The two greatest strengths of IBM SPSS statistics software are its drop-down menus to simplify data analysis and its capabilities with data handling. SPSS is excellent for data cleaning and structuring. We're going to dive deeper into how to sort your data as part of data cleaning. Before you can analyze the data, you need to clean and organize the data. To understand your data, you will very often want to sort a particular variable in ascending or descending order. In fact, some procedures in SPSS require you to sort data before you can use those procedures. There are two ways in which you may want to sort data. The most common is to sort cases, known as a row sort. But there may be times that you want to sort variables, which is known as a column sort. When you sort data, all of the data in the dataset will be sorted based on a single variable, but the information in each case will stay together. So for example, we have three people, each with a different measure for age, height, and income. If we sort the income variable from smallest to largest, each person's data from the other variables stays with them. So here's how sorting works. When we sort ascending by age, the youngest person is sorted to the top of the data, and the ages get larger or ascend as we move through the data. If our data are words, then sort ascending will place them in alphabetical order. We can also sort descending so that the largest numbers stay on top and descend through the column of data. For this example, we are using the demo.sav dataset that comes with SPSS. To find out how to open this dataset, check the links in the description. And I should warn you about sorting cases that it is not possible to unsort the data once they have been sorted. You cannot return the data to their original order. So if you want to preserve the original order of the data, be sure that you create a unique identifier to number the cases first. If you need to add a unique identifying number to your cases, go to Transform, Compute Variable. We will call our new target identity variable ID. For the numeric expression, begin by clicking on the function group All. You want this function. Drag that into the numeric expression formula window and click OK. In data view, we can see our new case numbers. If you ever sort your data set using some other variable, you can use this new case number to return your data to its original order. The quickest way to sort cases in SPSS is in data view. Right-click, or control-click on Mac, and select sort ascending, or sort descending. If you ever change your mind and you want to go back to the original order, right-click on the ID variable, the new one that we just created, and choose sort ascending. SPSS considers missing values to be the smallest value. So missing values will appear first if you sort in ascending order and will appear last if you sort in descending order. You can also sort cases using the drop-down menu. Go to Data, Sort Cases. The Sort Cases dialog box is displayed. Move Age in Years variable to the Sort By list, and then click OK. Sorting by one variable is nice, but you can also sort by one variable within a second variable. Use the Dialog Recall button to bring back the Sort Cases dialog box. We are already sorting by age. But we can add the household income in thousands category and click OK. When you sort by multiple variables, SPSS sorts the second within each level of the first. So we are sorting income categories within ages, and that is not particularly useful. Whenever your results do not look as expected, it's usually easy to fix. Use the dialog recall button to bring back the Sort Cases dialog box. Drag income category above age. Click OK. Now SPSS sorts age within each category of income, starting with the smallest category. But what if you want to have the largest category on top? Easy to do. Use the dialog recall button to bring back the Sort Cases dialog box. We are sorting the age variable ascending, but we can sort the income category descending so that the larger incomes are on top. Click OK. The data are sorted by income category in descending order and are then sorted by age in ascending order. You can save the sorted data as their own dataset using the Save File with Sorted Data checkbox, then click File to specify a name and a location for the new dataset file. Although less common than sorting cases, you can also sort variables. When you sort variables, you can rearrange them in Variable View, which also rearranges them in Data View. Select Data, Sort Variables. Select the attributes that you want to use for sorting. We will sort by name first. Because your variable names must start with a letter, this technique would alphabetize them. We can select whether we want that sorting to be ascending, alphabetical, or descending. Reverse alphabetical. But you could also sort variables based on any of these other attributes, or by a custom attribute. For example, you could sort variables by number of decimals or alphabetically by labels. When you're finished, click OK. Your variables are sorted in ascending order according to their names, alphabetically. You will probably not do this very often, but knowing how to sort variables is most beneficial when you have a large data set, especially one in which you are not familiar with all of the available variables.